Namaste, welcome to Sarachandra AS Academy. As you know, the Nobel Prize have been announced. So today we will discuss the Nobel Prize for Physics. So this year, the Nobel Prize has been awarded equally to two scientists. One is Dr. Hoffman, another one is Dr. Hinton. So the reason they got the Nobel Prize is for the development of neural networks and transformers. So the development of neural networks and transformers, which has enabled the new race for artificial intelligence. So the current artificial intelligence so for example, every day you use products like ChatGPT or Microsoft Copilot. So this ChatGPT, DALL-E, so all these softwares work on a primary principle, that is through the machine learning. Through machine learning, these softwares are able to understand the context of a sentence or the context of a picture. For example, if you give a picture to the DALL-E software, so if you give a picture and ask, describe the picture, it will give an accurate definition. So this is possible because of the work of these two scientists. So what these scientists did was they developed a method of neural networks training. So that is, when there is a piece of information, for example, if we have given the software a picture of a person, so this picture of a person, when you give it to the software stores this picture in the form of pixels. So that is a series of 0 and 1. So that is how a picture is stored in the computer. So this is a revelation which has been there since the early 1920s, the use of digital numbers for storing. But after that, what happened is the field of neural networks started progressing. So in case of neural networks, what happens is the scientist try to mimic the neurons in the brain. So they try to mimic neurons in brain. So what is this mimicking neurons? So in a brain, we have lot of neurons. So if you remember from your childhood, so the neuron looks like this. So if somebody is watching online, I suggest all of you to learn how to draw these diagrams through hand. So don't cut, copy and paste the diagrams. So that is the reason why we are not using PPT today. So we want to learn to draw how this neural networks looks like. Now, these neural networks will be integrated with other neurons. Suppose there is another neuron here. So this neuron will be integrated through numerous chains to other networks. So this point of contact is called as synapse. Now, the important thing we need to understand is how neurons work. Suppose The brain has, let's say, 10 neurons. So these neurons constantly communicate with each other. For example, if you are talking to somebody, let's say the information is passing through these nodes. So the more of the activity you do, for every particular activity there is a specific path a neuron takes. So the more you do this activity, the more the neural connections strengthen. So as more and more activity pass through this network, what happens? The more and more stronger this neurons becomes. So that is the reason why, you know, in UPSC we say the more you write answer practice, the more better your subject will get, because the neural networks will get strengthened. So using these principles, what this scientist did was, they have created a machine called as Boltzmann machine. So the aim of this Boltzmann machine is very simple. So what they do is, similar to neurons, they will create something called as nodes. So now what happens is, they will pass the information through these nodes. So similar to neurons, they will pass the information through these nodes. This will pass in a complex manner and it will give an output. Now what happens is, this scientist will give input to this neuron through training data. So they will train the neuron, they will train this neural network using the existing data. For example, they are feeding it a picture of the cat. So when the cat picture pass through, certain neurons get activated. Let's say the cat has a pathway like this. So whenever a neural pathway is being taken, the scientists have observed, what do they represent? So they have assigned the value of 0 and 1. So if this neuron is passing like this, so these are activated. So hence they have allotted a value of 0. Hence wherever this is touching, so they have allotted a value of 0. Whatever the nodes this is not touching, they have allotted a value of 1. So by this method, what the scientists did was, they were able to identify a pattern. They have identified the pattern of information flow for various objects. That is, a picture of a dog will create a different neural network. A picture of a cat will create a different neural network. So based on the characteristics of the pathway an image is taking, they are able to identify what image it is. So now, after the training is completed, what they did was, they have started sending incomplete data. So into this neural network, which has already been trained, they have started sending incomplete data. For example, you want to remember the, let's say, second Prime Minister of India. So you want to remember second Prime Minister of India, what do you think? So okay, fine, I don't know who is second Prime Minister, but I know first Prime Minister, it is Jawaharlal Nehru. So second Prime Minister would have come after Jawaharlal Nehru. So what happens is, you will start thinking about the neurons, thinking about the information that is associated with that first information which you don't remember. So in the same way, when I am sending an incomplete picture, suppose I am sending a picture of a man without a head, so there is no head, this part is missing. So if I send an image like this, what happens? Because there is no head, if the image is complete image, it would have passed through like this. Let's say this is a pathway of a man. Now because we are sending an image which is having an incomplete picture or an incomplete data set, what happens? The neural network will take a different path. So it will have, it will go like this, but instead of this final node, will go like this because there is no head. So because of this, there is a difference in the information. Now, what the scientists did was, they know what kind of deviations happen. If there is a head, it will pass through this. If there is no head, it is passing through this. So they were able to complete the incomplete data. So when the incomplete data is fed into the neural network, it is able to synthesize the missing information. Based on training data. So this is not random guess, this is based on training data. So that is how the scientists are able to use neural networks to understand the pattern of growth. So let us do a quick recap. So what happens? In human brain, based on repetition of activity, the neural networks gets strengthened. Similarly, when you train a neural network machine, what happens? Based on training data, it is able to understand patterns. In the next stage, it is able to predict patterns. Predict missing data based on patterns. So this has led to the development of new kind of artificial intelligence called as generative AI. The generative AI is nothing but which will predict based on the pattern. So for example, if you ask an artificial software to generate an image of a cat, so it doesn't understand what is a cat, what is a dog, but what it understands is the word cat is associated with certain neural pattern. So it will try to mimic that neural pattern and create a new image of a cat which is not existing before. So their work have been very, very phenomenal in developing the generative AI that we use every day. So that is the reason why they got Nobel Prize. If you see the history of UPSC, so UPSC has asked two questions as of now from previous Nobel Prizes. One is the use of blue LED, which has been awarded the Nobel Prize. The discovery of blue LED has been awarded the Nobel Prize. It has been asked in the previous year question. The second one is about Einstein-Bose quantum set. So both of them are scientific in nature. So UPSC has asked these kind of questions in the previous year. So there is a very, very good scope for asking what is generative AI and what are neural networks. So there is a scope for asking such a question in mains 2025, like what is generative AI and neural networks. Explain their significance. So if any of you are interested in writing this answer, please write and send to us in an email. Thank you.